boys and girls at Zynga, as promised, I have one more awesome idea to check out at home, and I wanted to use our Kanto blocks to show you. The concept is called Subitizing. And the gentleman, Patrick Greenwood, who created Kanto blocks, wrote this card up to help us understand what we should do. It says, to subitize is the inborn skill we humans and some animals possess where we can quickly know the quantity of objects in a small set without counting each item. The human limit is thought to be 7 objects, though some researchers state the number is closer to 5, and above that we add smaller sets together in our heads. It is believed this skill evolved to allow parents to quickly assess that all of their children were present. What a valuable skill for a parent to have. Research shows that the practice of subitizing helps children build number sense, and that subitizing small sets together leads to operational thinking such as composition and adding together. With STEM blocks, you can guide your child in subitizing activities using trays, bits, as well as cards. Let's try some subitizing together. So the challenge is, can you look at this tray and without counting, can you say how many you would need to fill it? How many bits? I think we would need 1, 2, 3. If you thought it was 3, you were right. Let's do another one. Here's a good one, boys and girls. Without counting, how many smiley faces do you see? Is it this many or this many? Let's see what fits on that tray. 1, 2. You can do this with many different numbers and many different combinations. Let's try one more. How many bits do you have there? Would they fit on this tray? Or would they fit on this tray? I think I have 1 too many for that tray. Do you know how many that is without looking? Can you match it to the card? Is this the right card? It's hard not to count them, boys and girls, isn't it? I see 1, 2, 3, 4. I needed the 4 tray to do that one. Let's try another one. I will put out these cards and see if you can tell me which ones equal, which card equals the number I put out. Does it look like this one? I don't think so. Too many. Does it look like this one? I don't think so. Which one of these is it? Well, I can tell you it's this one. In which tray would that be? Maybe I'm gonna put it this way, just in case it won't fit. You can tell just by looking that there's too many to fit in this tray. I think it goes in this tray. Let's see if my guess is right. There are this many, which is actually 5, boys and girls. Another way we play this at home or at school in circle time is if you take a dice and you look for that number without counting until you can match it. And if you're 5, boys and girls, or 6, you can also maybe figure out if you can match the words to that as well. Playing with numbers is fun, boys and girls. Subitizing is really fun. It's good for your brain. You can also stack them in different ways. And notice that they look different. And is it harder to count them or to visualize them in one way versus the other? There's so many fun things you can do with contour blocks or with any kind of items or blocks at home to get your brain working and thinking about quantities, objects, and numbers. Thank you for listening, and go check on a hunt and try to get some objects to count or subitize. Have a great day.